Hi, a very good morning. I am Lakshmi Narayana Gunta, PGT in Zoology at APMS and Junior College Karvanjam, and also working as NEET Super 60 Zoology faculty at Dukkurvalsa, Srikakulam. Today, we are going to discuss the excretory products and their elimination, part 2. Under this part, we are going to discuss the human excretory system. The human excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, a urinary bladder, and a urethra. These are a pair of kidneys. The sac-like structure is the urinary bladder and the urethra. Okay, let us discuss all these things one by one. Kidneys are the reddish brown bean-shaped structures. They are a pair in number, and the right kidney, it is slightly lower than the left kidney. Why? Why the right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney? Because of the presence of the liver on the right side, right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney. These kidneys, they are situated one on either side of the backbone, close to the dorsal inner wall of the abdominal cavity. These kidneys, they are located between the 12th thoracic vertebra and the 3rd lumbar vertebra. This one is the 12th thoracic vertebra, and this one is the L3, 3rd lumbar vertebra. In between these two, the kidneys, a pair of kidneys are located. Okay, here you can observe the right kidney is slightly lower than the left one. We are observing this from the dorsal side. Okay, coming to the measurements of the kidney, each kidney is 10 to 12 centimeters in length and 5 to 7 centimeters in breadth and 2 to 3 centimeters in thickness. The thickness of the kidney is 2 to 3 centimeters. On an average, a kidney weighs about 120 to 170 grams each. And these kidneys, on the outer side they are convex, on the inner side they are concave. This one is the convex surface and this one is the concave region. Human kidneys, they are retroperitoneal organs. What do you mean by retroperitoneal organ? This is the dorsal view. This is the image from the dorsal side. Retroperitoneal organs are those organs which are covered only on the ventral side by parietal peritoneum, and dorsal side it is not covered by parietal peritoneum. What do you mean by parietal peritoneum? The serous membrane lining the cavity of the abdomen, covering the abdominal organs, is called as serous membrane. Here in this diagram you can clearly observe the blue colored lining is all the parietal peritoneum. These two are kidneys. These kidneys, they are covered by this parietal peritoneum, serous parietal peritoneum, only on the ventral side, but on the dorsal side it is not covered by parietal peritoneum. That's why human kidneys, they are called as retroperitoneal organs. This is the cross section of the abdominal cavity. Okay, where we can observe kidneys, spleen, pancreas, large intestine, small intestine, etc. The inner side of the kidney, it is having a fissure called as the hilum or hilus. This hilum or hilus, it is meant for the entry of the renal artery and exit of the renal vein. This one is the renal artery which brings in the oxygenated blood with nitrogenous waste products to the kidney. This is a renal vein. It carries deoxygenated blood, and the kidneys, they filter the nitrogenous waste products. This one is called as the hilum. This hilum provides an exit way for ureter. This ureter, it carries urine to the urinary bladder. Okay, na? There are two distinct regions in a kidney. The outer dark colored region is called as the cortex. This one is the cortex, and the inner light colored region is called as the medulla. Okay, this medulla is divided into renal pyramids. These renal pyramids, they are separated by projections of the cortex called as columns of Burtini, also called as the renal columns. The projections of the cortex into the medulla, which separate the renal pyramids, are called as columns of buttony or renal columns. Here you can clearly observe the renal columns. Okay, ma'am. The base of each pyramid originates at the border between the cortex and the medulla. And this pyramid, renal pyramid, it terminates in renal papilla. This one is renal papilla. These renal papillae, they project into cup-like structures called as calyces. These calyces, they are formed by the funnel-shaped pelvis. This funnel-shaped pelvis forms cup-like structures called as calyces. This cup-like structure is called as calyx. Let us observe the difference between all these parts. That one is the renal pyramid and the renal papilla. Renal papilla project into a cup-like structure called as calyx, and the calyx, they are formed by the funnel-shaped pelvis. That one is pelvis where the urine is collected, and this continues as ureter. Okay, na? Each kidney, it is formed by nearly 1 million nephrons. These nephrons, they are also called as uriniferous tubules. These are the structural and functional units of a kidney. After 40 years of age, these nephrons, they usually decrease by 10% for every 10 years. Suppose we have 1 million of nephrons by the age of 40 years. And by the age of 50, we may lose 1 lakh functional nephrons. And let us now move to the structure of a nephron. Each nephron has a Malpighian body and a renal tubule. This Malpighian body, it consists of a Bowman's cup and a glomerulus. This cup-shaped structure is called as the Bowman's cup. Within the Bowman's cup, there is a bunch of capillaries, which is formed by an afferent arteriole. Afferent arteriole means the arteriole which brings in the blood into the Bowman's cup. And efferent, E for exit, E for exit. Efferent arteriole, it takes away the blood from the Bowman's cup. Okay? Bowman's cup and this glomerulus together called as Malpighian body. Coming to the second part of a nephron is renal tubule. This renal tubule, it has three regions. The first region is called as the proximal convoluted tubule, PCT, which is also called as first convoluted tubule. And the second one is the distal convoluted tubule, DCT, second tubule. And connecting these two, the proximal convoluted tubule and the distal convoluted tubule, a hairpin shaped structure called as loop of Henle or Henle's loop. Okay, this is the structure of a nephron. The nephrons are classified into two types, the cortical nephrons and the juxtamedullary nephrons. These cortical nephrons, they are more in number when compared with juxtamedullary nephrons. These cortical nephrons, they are mostly the loop of Henle or Henle's loop. It is limited to the cortex region only. A small portion of this loop of Henle, it may extend into the medulla. The loop of Henle of these juxtamedullary nephrons is very large and extend deep into the medulla. This one is the cortex region and this one is the medullary region. And here you can clearly observe the loop of Henle, it is extended deep into the medulla. That's why they are called as juxtamedullary nephrons. As these nephrons, the loop of Henle limited mostly to the cortex region and it may extend a very little bit into the medulla. That's why they are called as cortical nephrons. And one more most important difference between these two is the efferent arteriole. I have already told you the efferent arteriole which exits the nephron. E for exit. The efferent arteriole, after coming out from the Bowman's cup, it forms a network of capillaries around the loop of Henle. This is called as peritubular capillary. Peri means on all the sides. Some peritubular capillaries run along the loop of Henle. They are called as vasa recta. This vasa recta is present in juxtamedullary nephrons, whereas this vasa recta, it may be absent or if it is present, highly reduced in cortical nephrons. Okay, we have finished the concept of kidneys And now let us move to the second part of the human excretory system, that is ureters. These ureters is a pair of slender whitish tubes which emerge out from the pelvis of the kidney through the hilum. These ureters, they measure nearly 30 centimeters in length and they run downward and join the urinary bladder. The walls of these ureters, they are made up of transitional epithelium, a specialized epithelium, okay, which is also observed in the urinary bladder. These ureters, they run down and open into the urinary bladder. They carry the urine to the urinary bladder. Coming to the next part of human excretory system, that is the urinary bladder. This urinary bladder is a medium storage sac, a sac-like structure. It is a pear-shaped structure situated in the lower abdominal cavity. Lower abdominal cavity. And this one is thick, muscular and highly distensible. And its wall is lined by transitional epithelium. This transitional epithelium, suppose it is having 5 layers during resting stage. When the urinary bladder is filled, then it may become 2-layered or 3-layered epithelium. That's why it is called as transitional epithelium. And our urinary bladder is capable of storing 300 to 800 ml of urine, which is collected by these two ureters. By the time this bladder is filled with 400 ml of urine, we feel the urge to pass out our urine. And even though it is filled with 400 ml, we can even store up to 800 ml of urine. Okay, na? And finally, the urethra. Urethra is a tube that takes urine from the urinary bladder to the outside. This one is the urethra. This urethra is 4 centimeters in females, whereas it is 20 centimeters in males. And this urethra is a common passage or a sharing duct in males, because males excrete urine through this urethra and also they send out the semen through this urethra. That means it is a sharing duct both for reproductive and excretory systems. Whereas in females, this urethra, it is only 4 centimeters in length, and females, they have a separate opening which is called as urethral orifice for sending out urine. Okay, this finishes the human excretory system. And in our next class, we are going to discuss the structure of a nephron and also the mechanism of urine formation. Okay, let us now finish this session with a few questions. The first one is, the columns of Bettini are formed between two limbs of Loofah Finlay, cortical and juxtamedullary, kidneys, renal pyramids. Okay, the right option is renal pyramids. Coming to the next question, structures of nephrons present in the cortex region of kidney or renal pelvis and papilla, Loofah Finlay and collecting duct, PCT, Loofah Finlay and DCT, Bowman's capsule, PCT and DCT. What is your option? Right, Bowman's capsule, proximal convoluted tubule and DCT is the right option, which are present in the cortex region of the kidney, whereas Loofah Finlay, it may extend even into the medulla. Okay, thank you for watching and follow me on YouTube simply by typing Lakshminarayana Gunta. Thank you.